Got the skid steer warming up, doing my pre-trip around everything, just making sure all the fluids are good on that. Had to top the antifreeze off from where the line broke last time we used it. So Barney should be good to go. No, you just got to do the good old tire kicks and make sure they're full of air, you know. And these 3-inch thick tires, you know, you can't tell if they got 20 or 100 in them. But they're round, so they'll roll. Let's go down here and get started on backfilling the pipe. So the concrete is dry now. I'm gonna push a little dirt in here and go ahead and pack dirt through that section right there. I'm gonna put the bucket back on the mini and rake that down so we can continue our lift all the way up here to the box. And then start bringing good clay in here and filling this area up. So we got all this cut down, pushed in there, rolled in, compacted around the pipe. I'm gonna go load out a few loads of clay and bring down here and dump it. We'll go ahead and get a good base put on top of that. Keep rolling it in. We'll probably put 2 or 3 feet in there. So I don't know, 8 or 10, 12 loads. Then I'll probably go ahead and stack that other riser on there.
We're good.
We're going to go set riser structure number 2. Get down here and get it set.
So I got the pipe grouted in and got the conceal top of this box cleaned off real good. 2 layers of conceal and the second structure. About to set it in place and that'll be riser number 2.
Alright, here we go. Look at that. Beautimous. What I'll do if I can get it unhooked. Take it and just kind of push it down on there. Probably stack that other one on top of it. That way it has all the weight on it. Before I grout anything. That way it can settle. It's going to settle any. But first I need to backfill enough where I can stand around it.
So we got that set. I put some dirt around it and compacted it in. I'm gonna go ahead and set the third one on top. That way it's got the maximum amount of weight on it that it's gonna have, and it'll finish squirting whatever conceal it does out for a good solid seal. So we got double runs. That's ideally what you wanna see right there. That's a good seal. It'll squirt out more once I put another 4,000 pounds on top. Let me get this mini out of the way.
Let's go set riser box number 3. Got some logs on there. Kind of chipped the other one. He accidentally, when he poured it, he put the holes on, because the boxes are poured upside down and the lifting ring, they're supposed to be at the top, so being at the bottom, it's putting a lot of weight at the top, but that kind of spans it out a little bit. So we're going to set this, it's warming up, and set this on there, go grab lunch. It'll settle what it's going to do. I'll mash it down with the excavator. Go ahead and backfill it and bring it on up. It looks like it's sealed so good, I'm just going to grout the inside of it. It's going to be buried about 5 feet in dirt, so I'll compact some good time. All right, all cleaned off. Ready to set. Thank you. bada-bing, bada-boom. Now how are we going to get it on?
Let the log fall on you.
That's quite the overflow system, isn't it?
That's what I wanted, right there. There, that's not going to leak. You want your conceal to squirt out like that. The two layers, that's a good seal. Especially that. The more it squirts out, the tighter fit it is. So we'll do good. There's a chip right there, I'll grout that. But we're good here. I'm gonna go ahead and backfill on up to about, I don't know, right here, and I'll probably grout this joint on the inside and outside just because it won't be 5 feet in the ground, and we will be good to go.
All right, we're loading out a couple more loads of dirt. That should finish our lift off, and he's going to spread that while I go down there and finish. Well, not finish, but start on pulling the back slope in, that mud and everything that I kind of piled up back there. I'm going to use that kind of on the back slope. Not the mud, but that kind of drier material, but it's not good clay that I wanted to put around the pipe. Start raking that out, getting that where it will dry some.
Two loads of dirt piled up and putting it around the box, rolling it in. So he's pushing around here with the skid steer, and I got the compaction wheel, and I'm just kind of
big packing.
truck into comparison. Skid steer in the Mini. Big pile of dirt. Skid steer, so it almost looks like we're back to where we started this morning, except for where we started this morning was way down there. So what I'll do is I'll end up grouting the inside of that one if water ever gets down to that one. Look how good that squirted out. I'll grout around that edge right there and throw a little bit around here. This is still going to get buried in the dirt to about right here, but packing around that dirt's real good. And yeah, that is water level right there, so there'll be a trash rack that sits on top of that. We got all this dirt put in here today and compacted in. It was a little time consuming, but it's a process that's got to be done. So now probably one more good day of hauling ought to be able to get this filled back in. I started taking that wetter material and that pile that was there, and I raked all that mud that I dug out. Maybe it'll dry some, and I'm going to take all this and I'll end up spreading some of this out on the bank right here and wasting it right in here. That pile will probably go over there. So coming along, have a majority of this done in about 2 to 3 more days, I would say. I still got to dig a lot out on the end of that dam where all that concrete is. But, yeah, I'm happy with it. Let's go home.